프로토스, 코드 S32가, 디조, 오지에스 나다, 이은열, 더 베스트 포 유, 김찬민, 본 프라임 위, 안호우, 오지에스타, 김정훈,
김찬민 선수.
아, 더 베스트 포 유, 김찬민 선수입니다.
순진하게 생기셔가지고.
어머머.
살짝 기분 나쁘기도 했어요. 만만하게 보는 것 같아요.
스타 원조 네. 이윤열 선수를 보고 했었거든요.
영광이겠네요, 여러 가지 대결을
하시고. 말하자면, 네.
훈훈한 분위기 속에서 진행됐던 것 같고요.
세란전에 강한 노련한 선수, 나다 이윤열. 스타크래프트 2에서도 레전드를 꿈꾸는 그를 상대로 더 베스트 포 유 김찬민은 어떤 수를 둘 것인가?
비밀이어야지.
비밀이
비밀. 네, 아, 모르겠어.
경기 전에 나가는 영상이에요? 아, 그럼 전략적인 거 많이 준비했습니다.
제가 좀 잘한다고 생각하긴 해요.
다 어렵게 생각되진 않고, 정훈이 떨고.
이윤열 선수랑 김정훈 선수가 떨어질 것 같아요.
디조의 유일한 프로토스, 안호우!
안호우!
안호우가 안호우를 골랐어요. 네.
남은 투수 중에요. 제일 만만한 것 같았어요.
김정훈!
저 김정훈! 오제스타 픽!
조준현식에서 빨리 안 뽑히더라고요. 무서워서 그런지 잘 안 붙더라고요.
안호우 선수한테 아주 재밌는 걸 보여드리겠습니다. 오!
재밌는 거 쓰기 전에 그냥 4차관으로 밀면 되니까.
안순이 안 나왔다고 해서 실망하지 마시고 즐겁게 감상해 주시기 바랍니다.
견고한 이윤열, 이윤열을 우상으로 삼아온 김찬민. 두 전사의 동독전에 이어
저도 좀 많이 어필하고 많이 알리고 싶어요.
플레이를 멋있게 하는 거는 시즌2 때 다 보여드렸다고 생각하고 이제는 이기는 게 목적입니다.
코드의 우승 김정훈과 스타일리시한 경기력을 선보인 안홍우. 두 전사의 상상을 초월한 대결까지.
토스전도 연습하지 않으면 큰일 날 테니까 연습 많이 하시도록.
그닥치 어려운 상대라고는 생각 안 해요.
디조의 전쟁은 이제 시작이다.
That's right. The group of D is now starting here at the GSL Code S.
Can I just reiterate?
Please.
How in love with Nada I truly am.
He is your biggest man crush.
He just said, I don't think anyone in this group is good except me and OGS Top. I love Nada so much, man. He's such a legend. He's
got,
such
like,
a badass.
Tears coming
He's so
down.
Smart.
He's so perfect.
We agree on everything. He and OGS Top certainly
I
are
like
my two
green
picks
tea.
Here.
He likes green tea. Perfect nerd.
Free pizza.
Free pizza today.
That's right. You come down sometimes. We got free pizza for everyone. Of course, if you're a vegetarian, you're screwed. But otherwise, have some free pizza. Yeah.
Yeah.
I'm sure you'll have a slice after this.
No, I'm not going to eat the pizza.
Not going to eat any pizza?
I've been trying to stay healthy.
Yeah, that's actually probably smart.
Been working out, you know. Someday I'll be casting this with no shirt on. Let these muscles do the casting. You know what I'm saying?
You'd be like going like this and shit.
Making my pecs bump like that.
Yeah.
Two bumps means GG. I don't know.
Do you like hear it rippling in your microphone or something? Okay.
So no pizza for me. So
anyways, Nada and OGS Top, definitely my picks to come out of this group. Without any doubt, those are my picks. If the best FOU gets out of this group,
I think
stars are going to have
to
align.
The only person who might come out if it's not a Top and Nada would be Hongun.
Yeah.
Because
Hongun is
crazy.
A very volatile player. He comes up with some crazy stuff from time to time.
현재테란 이윤열 선수, 천재다운 면모로 이번 시즌에도 꼭 챔피언이 되시길 응원합니다. 재밌는 컨트롤도 많이 기대할게요. 천재테란 이윤열 만세!
어거지테란 김찬민 선수, 이번 시즌 김찬민 선수만의 독특한 어거지 전략으로 꼭 높은 곳까지 오르시길 기원합니다. 힘내세요. 화이팅!
홍어 포격기 안홍욱 선수, 재밌는 게임 보여주셔서 너무너무 고마워요. 늘 인상적이었습니다. 항상 발전하는 모습 기대하겠습니다. 이번 시즌에도 문제 없으시죠? 파이팅!
코드A 챔피언 김정훈 선수, 코드S 챔피언도 문제 없죠? 자신감 넘치는 모습으로 트로피의 멋진 키스 기대해보겠습니다.
Well, we know the picks coming from Secret. Now the question is, are the predictions correct? Which member of Secret is actually the best StarCraft II analyst?
And it's also quite interesting that once again, one of each have chosen a player.
Yeah. Very, very fascinating. So again, our first matchup is going to be, of course, this group, very similar to our previous group, three Terrans.
Yes.
And then
it's Terran Thursday.
It is.
Jesus, get on the bandwagon. What's wrong
we
with you, man?
We got Nada against the best. And I got to say, Nada is definitely the favorite here. Nada is just as good at StarCraft 2 as he was at StarCraft 1. Very consistent, solid. Not quite with the results just yet, but when you watch the guy play, it's like, whoa.
Nada is basically a perfect human. He's as close as we've come so far in the evolution of man.
We've already taken his DNA. We're testing it. We're mixing it.
Yeah. He's just amazing.
I love him. He was actually Artosis' favorite pro gamer back when Artosis...
Well, that's not fair. It was I Love Ooh, but...
It was I Love Ooh?
It was I Love Ooh.
Oh.
But no, not a... Like, I have infinity respect. My second favorite.
Number two. As you can see from the GSL points, a fairly even, at least when you do the math of the results we've pulled together thus far, but I think if you look at the accomplishments, the history of pro gaming experience, you see Nada is really just like, just such a powerhouse.
Yeah, Nada, I mean, he is the legend Mises. I mean, a lot of people talk about Slayer's Boxer, but this guy's right in that same boat, you know, where he's been around since basically the beginning, and he's an unstoppable force of nature.
He really is.
Terran.
All right, the countdown's begun, so let's get ready for Nada against the best foe. You with Terran versus Terran. Old school. I got some pretty new school pro gamer here. Get ready. Okay, in the red, we have our first Terran player, the most consistent StarCraft 1 pro gamer of all time. Barely got that out. It was like 400 APM. Stay that way.
Yes, he can dance.
Yes, he can. There's Nada. Now to our other Terran player, definitely the underdog in this, representing the team FOU. He is.
FOU.
And there's a shot of him now. And we know who Kelly is rooting for. Now, onto this game. TBT, I love watching TBT in these spots. Mm. I mean, even though it's tough to play from, it's fun when you get to people that are this good. Yeah. Because this is something like, look, I played a lot of Terran versus Terran. It's probably one of my better matchups in StarCraft 2, but I'm obviously not as good as these two guys. So I want to see, what is the right way to play this out?
Well, you know, you said something quite interesting in there, is that, you know, it's difficult to play from, but makes very entertaining games. And I think that a lot of people don't realize that that is oftentimes the case. The hardest things to play normally come out to be the most interesting games. For instance, Desert Oasis.
Oh, yeah.
That was the hardest map to play early on in StarCraft II, but also gave us some of the best games.
Yeah,
again,
absolutely.
This position, as you said, gives us some great games, but very difficult to play. And it just seems to turn out like that quite often. There's more to admire when people do things well.
Yeah, absolutely. When the situation really calls for some tough calls.
That's right.
It can be a lot more fun to watch. By the way, special thanks to our sponsors, Intel and G-Skill.
Should it be G-Skill?
Not this time.
Not this
Can't
time.
Wear that joke out or toast. You need to settle down.
Oh, I'm sorry. Okay?
You're out of control. Give me your car keys, right?
Nada going for a super fast expansion. The best not going to see it.
The best actually should have gone up there.
Oh, my.
To be totally honest, he should have gone up there.
Well, I think he thought, okay, I'm not going to get up the ramp, so I'm not going to go. And what are the odds
That's
of the command center being right there? So, interesting decision, and it might cost him because, well, he's going actually for a fast expansion as well, a very fast one. But Nada's going to just be better because it is already down at the natural. He's going to be able to mine from it quicker.
Yeah, I mean, when you put the command center at the bottom, the only real risk you're running is what if I get rushed by something and that kills the SCV as it's making the command center. But that can't really happen in this matchup.
No.
In TBT. In TBZ. TBZ, you wouldn't want to do that.
He has the timing for that bunker down specifically so that that can't happen.
Mm-hmm.
So unless you double proxy raxed and hit it well from Nada, then he's going to be fine. Factory going up. What will Nada tech to? I don't know exactly, but now a Nada that I know would go Siege Shank Marine all game long. Just take the map and be like, LOL, I know how to macro perfectly. But by the place he actually placed that factory, I could see Banshee happening. I could see that.
You could see that?
I could see it, Tasteless.
Is that your vision?
Maybe.
Maybe.
But it's not, so I want to see the siege tanks that I know that he is just so good with. Well, time will tell, Tasteless. So stop bugging me about it.
Sorry, I'll drop it. Sometimes I'm selfish. Sometimes I'm a selfish bad man.
Sometimes you are.
Only care about yourself. Then we got a command center on the way. And a factory here. We're getting the add-on tech lab.
Ooh. We like have that. A quick armory from the best, as you see in the production tab.
You know, one of the best builds, if you want to just straight up try to win against a Terran that actually goes for fast expand as you do the Thor rush, it's actually really good. You do one base Thor.
Yeah, if they don't go Marauder, then you might do quite well with it.
Send 75%, 3/4 of your SCVs. Just repair the Thor while you're attacking. You'd be amazed how much damage you end up doing. You usually can end the game.
And Nada is making a siege tank. We see scans to see what his opponent is up to. Sees the command center, sees the two factories, gets all the information in the world through a single scan. And Nada, after getting a siege tank, does in fact go for Banshee, I believe. Or unless he's going to get
Is he going to get a Raven?
He might get a
Raven. Nope, Banshee.
I wouldn't be surprised if he does end up getting one, but he did see two factories from the best, so not really needed right now.
Yeah, true, true. Well, I mean, just having the Banshee out, because the other player can't tell if Cloak is coming, there's so much that they have to prepare for. Because as we saw in General versus Rainbow, one Banshee could just do an insane amount of damage. Go ahead, Artosis. I saw you wiggling your chair. You wanted to say something.
I am wiggling.
I saw your nerd body jerking around.
Because he's going Thor, Blue Flame Hellion.
Ooh.
That is an interesting unit combination. The Thors are going to be able to tank all sorts of damage and also deal damage very quickly. Whereas the Blue Flame Hellions, since the Thor is likely to be tanking a lot of the damage, can then go ahead and target Marines. So this could turn out to be quite good. We'll have to see. I haven't really seen this strategy used much in this matchup, especially against someone of Nada's caliber.
Yeah, I've never really seen this.
Nobody is. Nobody is, Tasteless. It makes me talk like this.
Now here comes the Banshee. This is to be predicted. Oh, man.
Oh, my.
Not even getting touched.
You want to talk about good micro, just talk about Nada.
Tell me about it.
It's great.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
It's awesome.
Thor chasing him. Banshee's like, I don't care. Chase me all day. Wow, this Banshee actually is getting a ton of kills, Stasis. Up to 6 kills already. Going to get 7 there. And skirt away before the Thor catches up.
Nice job there, delaying both the refineries. That actually is pretty big.
Yeah, and 7 kills. I mean, nothing small about 7 kills.
No, it's bigger than 6. Yeah. Definitely bigger than 5.
It's, like, way bigger than 5. It's twice in a third.
It's pretty hard to take 5 seriously when 7's around.
Because 7, 8, 9... 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Sesame Street, man.
Thank you, Artosis.
No problem. Anytime.
Now,
give a shout out to Elmo.
Let's just say Magic catches this game with Elmo. Actually, looks like the Banshee's going to be taken out, by the way.
And Nada is moving through the back very quickly now without siege tanks. His siege tanks are going to do wonders.
Yeah, they're going to be able to dictate, you know, the movement of all units during the battle.
Now it looks like he's going to take that down so quickly, Tasteless. Oh my, oh me, oh my! The best may be in a lot of trouble here. If I were him, I would be running those Blue Flame Hellions around the map right now.
Yeah, I was going to say you might want to go for the expansion or something. This is pretty bad, actually.
It's a hard decision to make, but I think it's definitely one he should have here. Because this is a terrible spot he's in. Nada getting way ahead. But if he could kill a ton of SCVs, he might be able to do some
frankly,
sort of...
Sorry, go ahead.
Oh, he is, in fact. Okay, gonna bring a Blue Hellion drop back.
All Nada has to do... I don't know if Nada's fully aware there are no siege tanks coming from our Blue Terran, the Foyu.
Well, he's just scanning.
The Foyu, what am I doing? Now, here's... the best chance to do a little bit of catch-up. Oh! Actually, I don't know if this is going to be enough.
Nope. Looks like he will kill off a good number of SCVs, but still.
Mostly just softening them up, though, to be honest. Yeah, that was pretty bad.
Meanwhile, the best is going to counterattack into the siege tank line. Thor is dealing sick damage, but not doing a great job with the Marines, running them back, running them far.
Touched.
Yeah, the siege tanks are taking almost no damage, but the Thor is being repaired very, very well. We do have a huge hit point amount, 400 hit points apiece.
That's quite a big amount.
Yeah, 72 supply for the best, 95 for Nana.
He's coming up the map now. All he has to do is get in range of that orbital, and, you know, the best foe he was going to have to hit his panic button.
I think he's already hit that button, Tasteless.
He's already pulled the fire alarm.
He slapped it three or four times and wondering where the firing squad is.
He's getting closer and closer.
And he's going to try this again. Thor is this time hitting some siege tanks.
The Hellion rendered useless.
And the siege tank's being turned out very, very quickly. Good move by the best.
You know what? Well done by the best. He actually held that off.
Yeah. All four Thors staying alive this time. All of them with a lot of kills. I bet Nod is actually just slightly surprised that he lost all that without killing any of the Thors.
Well, I think the situation where he actually drove the Thors back, he might have wanted to regroup. You're not playing against a player who's making siege tanks, which means you don't have to worry about trying to hold a position.
Yeah.
Like you can't reclaim it later on.
Now, during all this, Nada has been taking a third base as well. He's ahead.
I can't believe he's taking the third base there.
Yeah, that's a funny place
to take it. Of all the locations to take a third base?
100% I would make it far away. Your opponent's going Thors. They're slow. But, you know, he's got a good siege tank line.
He doesn't have strike cannon, does he?
I don't believe he does.
I haven't messed with strike cannon very much in TDT, so I don't actually have any comment on it, really. But
maybe if it's Thor versus Thor.
Actually, yeah.
But if it's Thor versus Siege Tank, I don't think so. Actually,
if it's Thor versus Thor, yeah, you'd want to use it then. It's a good observation.
Thank you.
Looks like it's the best turn. Bunker's not very good against Thors.
No, not so much. Well, right now, supply-wise, we have 109 for Nada, 101 for the best. So really, that last cleanup helped him out so much. 41 SCVs for the best, 56 for Nada. So actually, supply-wise, army-wise, the best has a slightly larger army right now.
Yeah.
Not as though very siege tank based. The best is starting to do some tricky play now.
Now he's incorporated siege tanks with the Thors.
That's pretty cool.
I think Nod is probably saying, why didn't I listen to Tasteless to make my expansion elsewhere?
But he did listen to Tasteless on something else, and his third command center is an orbital, not a planetary, so he's going to lift that off.
That's
and
good.
Go find a new home. Now we do. Ooh, never mind. Nada taking yet another command center. Nada just has to hold on right now.
You know, it's so weird on this map. So much of the action ends up in this gully.
Yeah.
Down here. And that means you can move around the map and expand elsewhere. And oddly enough, the best has not yet spotted a command center. That patrol route is not good.
Yeah, that's quite true. Now, the best is going to have to start thinking about taking a third base. This game's going a little bit long. Nada's in a really entrenched position, which means that it's time for people to start expanding. Eventually in TBT, you get into these areas where it's going to be unbelievably hard to actually kill each other. And when that happens, you need to take a lot of bases, because when you can't kill someone well, what that means is you can, but you need to have a ton more than them.
I think the best is realizing, even though he held up that attack, he's in a pretty bad spot. All right, he's gonna patrol there, I guess, try to see if the SCV is gonna take some splash damage.
Nada's out in the middle of the map with a small force, whereas the best has a huge killer sick force. I mean, he's got four Arnies in there, man.
I mean, basically, Nada has economics, but the best has the raw strength. But we'll see about that.
Well, now with all
more siege tanks and siege mode,
yeah. While I think that the best can break that, it would be pretty costly to do so.
Well, he's pretty far away from his base, so it's hard to reinforce.
You know, leading with the Thors, he might be able to get something done here, but I don't know if he wants to. That
we don't get
so
to see this unit
shanks.
Composition battling, so it's kind of a tough call.
Yeah, no, it is. And I think he's looking at it, he's like, it looked like he was getting ready to engage a couple times. He's like, no, I don't think so.
And then he was like, probably something like that.
Yeah. And now he's just like, all right, living with his decision.
You see there's a lack of certainty in the way he's moving his army around.
Yeah, he's kind of all
over
the place.
It's almost like he's thinking out loud.
Yeah. I like that. That's a good way to put it.
Thank you.
He's thinking out loud through the motion of
through
the art
of
dance.
Interpretive dancing of the units on the map.
Yeah. Well, that has to be annoying. Not a single Marine. Heroes down that SCV, going to way slow down that expansion. Now, Nada does have an interesting drop coming up. There it is.
And that's headed towards the command center. I got to say, this is going to be a tough situation if he doesn't get back over there, because the best foe you needs this base up. Oh, what? He's like, wait. I'm surprised he didn't actually go for that and just take out that command center. I think that was bad decision-making by Nada. It would have been much better, yeah, to just drop everything there and ensure that command center is canceled or destroyed.
Yeah, you may have thought that the best units were a little bit closer to that.
Yeah, I think that's exactly what he thought. Whoop, almost got it.
Yeah, down to 86 health. That's what, one Marauder shot?
Must be. Maybe half of Marauder
There's
shot
like
Artosis.
There's like a few really angry Terrans like, oh, Artosis.
Oh, stop, buddy, Artosis.
Stop it. What are you? It doesn't do that amount.
Remember when you were saying that Zerg was hard and we didn't tell anybody that you've been playing Protoss for the past 2 months? We're like, he's biased because he's a Zerg. It's like, well, guys, actually, we tricked you.
Fun times.
Yep.
Well, Nada has a pretty sick siege line. That is actually not just pretty sick. That's almost as sick as I was the other day, Tasteless.
Yeah.
That is not a siege line you want to attack into. But you know, we might see an excellent siege of Nada's factories.
This would be something in the best direction.
Nada in a lot of trouble.
Well, this is going to force Nada to react. Very nice.
Got Nada sieging up just outside of the vision of the best tanks. Getting some hits off in there. And killing a factory. Wow, it's going to make him lift off and move some other ones as well. The best playing a very, very strong game. I'm very surprised how well he's playing.
Yeah. Well, this is going to change the way everything's operating, because Nada's gone for pure ground forces.
Ouch. And another factory's going to go down. The siege tank inside, that siege tank will never see the light of day.
And here comes Nada. He's just going to try to rip this apart real fast.
Well, the Marauders certainly helping out a bit. The tanks down there have been damaged some. And it ends up not working out all that
frankly,
well.
Frankly, Nada can afford to do that. Look at the minimap. The left side is dominated by Nada's
force. Nada's actually starting to show you guys what StarCraft 1 Pro, top pro gamer looks like. I mean, in the top left right now, he has this huge tank line, first off. But in the top left, he is building so many production facilities. Mass starport, mass factory. He's like, time to start spending the money.
Here he goes.
So the best deciding it is time to move.
It's a lot of siege tanks.
Taking a lot of damage, but should not be stopping for missile turrets. He's got to keep those Thors on a very move, attack, move, attack, move, attack command. And Nada with Marauders rolling down the ramp, going to take out the rest of the best forces.
And, this is pretty good. By Nada, I don't know, that might be the biggest point in the game that's going to cost the best of the game.
Yeah.
He seems to have just wanted to kind of shove his way into the base.
Yeah.
And it's just not going to happen.
Yeah. And now the best has actually scanned the top left. So now he's going to know what kind of trouble he's actually in.
Yeah.
Poor guy.
All right, here we go. It's now Nada's turn to be the aggressor. Nada's been patient enough. Nada sees that there is.
Nada's actually attacking everywhere, Tasis.
Yeah, not even the rocks are safe.
He's all over the place.
Very nice by Nada.
Hitting that gas. He's even going to the main base through the back hall. and sieging up in the main base right now. There it is.
Very nice. Yeah, he's
the best.
He's taking advantage of the fact that the best doesn't have a large army.
Yeah, the best
threw it away, can't defend everything everywhere.
He's half the supply, 113 to 200. Nada has insane production facilities. If he even lost his entire army, he'd be remaxed very, very quickly.
And honestly, I think in a moment here, yep, is what I was about to say. We're going to see him burst through the moment. I mean, burst through the entrance.
Well, he burst through the moment as well, Tasis, because that moment has passed.
He
is charging forward with Marauders and gets the best down to nothing left.
You know, Nada did a great job taking the whole map on the left side and then just switching right into Marauders because he says, okay, my opponent's just going Thors and tanks. He's got three factories. Even when he only had like three bases, that's a lot.
Well, we see that Nada has sieged up in the center. He's got a lot of Marauders, as you said. He's making a lot of Tech Lab starports. Yeah, he's just so far ahead. Starting to make a lot of Banshees now. Has some Vikings out. Getting the Banshee cloak. And I think it's just a matter of time before the best GGs it. Because he's about to lose his third and fourth bases.
Yeah, that should be GG here with this last move. He's breached his opponent's base. He's going to take out the command center. The best not even lifting. And that's all she wrote, man.
Yeah, it's the end of her story.
It's the end of her story. Don't make her write anymore. She's tired. She's sick like Kratosis was. Now, I think the best is sort of digesting this loss.
Yeah.
Knowing he's going to have to play either Hongun Prime or OGS Top next.
Not a situation I'd want to be in.
No.
Well, the best is moving through the back of the map. You know, we saw some great moves by the best this game. I love some of his Thor usage on top of the cliff, breaking Nada's contain. But this little siege tank Hellion Force is not going to stop those three Banshees.
You know what Nada's doing? If you notice, he's masking up Banshees and it's up in the upper left location. Because he knows that right now the best can't afford to get anti-air.
Yeah.
So he's just going to surprise him. So the best right now thinking he's doing some sort of base trade, but actually there's a ton of Banshees.
Yeah. Banshees are on
the
way.
They're about to show up. Some on our chosen screen. They're on the way. They'll be there soon.
It's 59 supply against 200. And they're all even going to cloak. He's not going to see them.
GG. Well played.
Indeed.
A well-deserved win there from Nada. Nada.
Nada.
Nada. Nada, you did it.
Ta-da. Nada. Yeah. Won the match.
Yeah, it looks like I'm casting like with a 10-year-old son I ever had. Well, the best was way outclassed there. He definitely deserved to lose that game. Obviously, he's not a bad player, but Nada's just that good.
And Nada's now we're going to go. Man.
He is. He's so sick. Now, Hongun Prime against OGS Top.
This is going to be pretty fun. Hongun has done reasonably well against Terrans in the GSL so far. In fact, made the first carrier versus a Terran. A good Terran, too, is JSL Zenith.
Yeah, that guy's good.
He's going up against OGS Top, who won Code A really strongly and says Terran versus Protoss is his best matchup. I believe him. He's super duper good at it. If you can beat OGS Top at PBT, you deserve to go to the round of 16.
Yeah,
so,
man.
We're going to see, can Hongun Prime do it? And if not, can he beat Nada?
It's kind of hard to do, Artosis.
Beating Nada at anything is hard to do.
Terran versus Terran Thursday here at the GSL.
It's Terran Thursday, man.
It's Terran Thursday.
Yeah.
We both start with T.
That's right.
So, kind of goes together.
Don't make fun, Tasis. Get with it.
Get with the program.
Terran Thursdays.
Terran Thursdays.
Zerg Wednesdays, and you know why?
What other day of the week would we possibly put with Terran, you know, day of the week, insert day of the week here? None. Terran Thursdays.
I hope Wednesday we have a lot of Zergs, though, because, in fact, you had all Zerg yesterday, didn't you?
Yeah, we had all at least a Zerg in each game, yeah.
Yeah. Zerg Wednesdays, because guess what? Z and W, they're not used too much, and they're both at the end of the alphabet. Makes perfect sense.
It does. It makes perfect sense.
There you go. All right, so there's Hongun He's ready. Are you ready?
I'm ready.
I'm ready.
I was born ready.
Toph is ready.
I came out of the womb and the doctor said, Taysom, are you ready? And I went, I'm ready. Okay, we got to start the game. I'm not talking.